in the Word, you see that, for instance, page 2, here's the Photoshop file and the table. You see this, place, and if I hold down Shift while I do that, because that's first select, and I'm going to Shift click open. Then what you get is a host of options on how you want to import the Word file. This is the advanced options for placing a Word file. Preserve styles formatting. I want to preserve page breaks. We click OK. It warns us there's some missing fonts, which is strange because they're not missing. They've been artificially stylized as italic, but I have them on my system, which FlightCheck sees. Anyway, other movie, right? And this is what we get. And there you get the full 3 pages. And what you see right away is that this text and the word art didn't come on the right page. The word art disappeared. The text frame completely disappeared. The text runaround is, of course, no longer there because the frame's gone. Does a good job with these fonts and these images. And it did a pretty good job with the table. I was kind of surprised with that. But in any event, you'll see once again why it's important to use Markzware PDF2DTP to make your job and your life a lot easier. All right, now here's the Markzware way. What we're going to do is up top in InDesign, you'll see the Markzware products, and in particular PDF2DTP, which we're going to use now to convert a PDF into InDesign. So what we need to first do is go back into that Word file, open up the Word file, which you can see here, and a 3-page file, and we're going to save it out as a PDF. PDF is a great way to interchange documents, portable document format, not for nothing, right? So this is one customer had a problem. He needed to get the embedded images, but not only the images, he needed the whole layout structure, at least as close as possible. It'll save him hours, days of work, right? So here's the PDF file. So now we just go into InDesign or Markzware, PDF2DTP, convert PDF. And now we're taking effectively that Word file via the PDF and converting it right into InDesign. So a host of preferences. You can tinker with these to get all kind of, you know, different results sometimes. Click OK. PDF2DTP will convert the entire PDF right into InDesign with a click, and in seconds, there it is. And what you'll see, it looks exactly like it just did in Word, InDesign file, that PDF2DTP just converted, and drop it on FlightCheck. But most importantly, I'm going to hide colors for right now. Not that they're not important, but we get all of the fonts that were used right on in to the new file and available for packaging. And we get all the images used at the resolution. So very effective. And if we go to page layout, I can actually go back into the file. In this case, it's launching CC. I've set up CC. Doesn't matter. And we actually go into the file, and we see that it's exactly like it was in Word. We get the Word art. We get the text frame, the text runaround. We get all the images used. The only thing is, in EPSs, we create an actual vector-based graphic. You copy, you go like an Illustrator, and you paste it in. So that's how you can, if you want to get a hard image here and save it out. But then in effect, you have it already in your InDesign file, but if you need the image itself, that's how you... One method is to, as the Bob tutorial highlights, to turn the doc, create the Word file into a DOCX, put a .zip extension, open it up, and you get the media in there. Oops, sorry. You get the media in here. There are some drawbacks to that with EPSs. Or the other option is use Markzware's PDF2DTP for CC or CS6. And older versions for Windows and Mac as well. And there you can get all your images extracted automatically as TIFF files at resolution used, at size used, and you get the complete layout within the InDesign format. I'll here with all kind of graphics and text and stylization. Pretty complex document, okay? Save as also a PDF. Word file here. Let's go into InDesign. File, new document. Print document. Command D. And we choose the word, the DOCX file. And we hold Shift. You see now it's doing a lot more processing. A lot of work going on, a lot of missing fonts. That's fine in this case. And we place it. And this is what we get. You know, not terrible. Let's get rid of this preflow here. We use flight check anyway, right? It's not terrible. But there's definitely work touching up to be done. So let's leave this one open. Let's now go into Markzware PDF2DTP convert PDF file. And file, but now the PDF, we exported out of it seconds ago. We can even substitute missing fonts, which could be quite useful. We're not going to do it in this case. There you go. Look at that. I mean, what do you see right away? Well, right away you see we preserve the file name. Not a big deal, but... And also you see the way it looks right away. It looks a lot better. I cruise down to like here, and you see this... Then you see down here the exploring the Arctic, how that should look, right? And we go over here and PDF2DTP. Well, you see, look at that. It does it just exactly the same. Exactly the same. Exploring the Arctic, exactly the same. Really, really amazing. Over here to the InDesign CC method. What we see is that everything is shifted and it's not exactly the same as in the native original layout. So just another side example to show you a real-life document how powerful Markzware's PDF2DTP is. If you need more information on Markzware's PDF2DTP to extract images or recreate entire layouts from Word or from PDF files that come from any source, really, then Markzware's PDF2DTP will do the trick. As you just saw, it's easy as a click to convert PDF files right into InDesign. The conversions are sometimes really amazing, and it's really easy to do. Some touching up may be required, but Markzware's PDF2DTP is a great tool for every graphic designer to have in their toolbox. You can buy PDF2DTP here. Just click the Buy Now button. And we look forward to servicing your order.